Hello friends, today subject science 10th English medium and chapter 3 continue last topic our. So myself Chetan Thakur start chapter number 3. Last time we discussed about metallurgy and refining of metal from in the earth crust last, and today last topic is corrosion. First we understand what is corrosion, and after understand corrosion how to prevent corrosion from metal. So first understand what is corrosion. Corrosion is metal contact with air moisture in long time. So matter covered with oxide layer, this type of oxide layer is damaged matter, and this process is known as corrosion. Suppose CU matter contact with CO2 gas in long time, and metal carbonate residue, and this metal carbonate residue is greenish color residue. In similar way, Fe metal long time contact with air moisture down, and Fe rust, and this Fe rust is known as iron oxide, Fe3O4, Fe2O3. So understand corrosion with some activity. First activity, take 3 test tube. First test tube A, B and C. 3 test tube. In 3 test tube, Fe nails. Put Fe nails in same in all 3 test tube. Fe nails. In first test tube, take water and close top part. In second test tube, water and above layer is oil and close top part. Here is air, in similar way here air is here air. Now put another substance, calcium anhydrous. Calcium anhydrous is substance absorb all moisture in test tube C. So after some time we observe one by one test tube. So first test tube we observe nails is corrosion. It means Fe nail is brown color and nails is corrosive. Second test tube B, water plus air. So here air does not contact with Fe metal. So test tube B, Fe nails is not corrosive because here oil layer is does not contact with metal and air. So we save. Third test tube is also not corrosive because substance we use calcium anhydrous, and this substance property absorb all moisture in test tube. So test tube is dry, and calcium anhydrous is known as drying agent. Ask board exam in VSQ 1 mark question. Calcium anhydrous is used as drying agent in industry. So test tube A is corrosion. Test tube B and test tube C is not corrosive because test tube B is protected by oil, and third test tube C is protected by calcium anhydrous drying agent. So, conclusion of this activity, when metal contact with air and moisture too long time, then metal is corrosive. So here we have example Fe after corrosion brown color residue and is known as rust iron. Cu metal contact with long time of CO2 gas and produce calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate color residue is greenish color. Now, how to protect metal from corrosions? Therefore, some steps to prevent metal. Prevention of corrosion. First step is painting. First step to prevention corrosion from metal, paint. It means paint metal. Suppose we have to save Fe metal. So around Fe metal surface we have to paint N, L, N. Stop contact by paint L to metal. Similar as test tube B, oil is not contact. Stop contact between air to metal, so your paint is not contact to air and Fe, so save metal. Next, now apply grease. Grease apply on metal surface, same purpose, not contact to air, moisture, so metal become prevent from corrosion. Third topic is galvanizing. Galvanizing means process to save or protect steel from rusting. So galvanizing, when use steel to use prevention to corrosion and not contact with air. Galvanize is one type of process. Next, make alloys. So what is alloys? Understand after some times. First, only understand prevent, how to prevent corrosion. Alloy is what? Understand sometimes. Next, another method to prevent corrosion, layer of another metal. It means one metal here, one metal covered with high reactive metal. Suppose metal A and metal B. To prevent metal A, we have to cover high reactive metal than A. So in this process, metal A can protect to contact directly contact with air. Metal A protect directly contact with air because metal B can cover as high reactive metal. So first contact of air moisture in atmosphere first react metal B. So metal A is saved, not corrosive. So in this process we have to protect metal from corrosion. Repeat once again. First is painting. Second is galvanizing, apply grease on the surface, alloys, make alloys, layer of another reactive metals. So if this is a step of prevent corrosion to and protect our metal. Now understand what is meaning of alloys. First understand what is meaning of alloys, and after understanding meaning of alloys, take some example. Alloys means homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture of metal, non-metal, or metal to metal. homogeneous mixture of metal and non-metal oblique metal to metal. It means two type of homogeneous mixture take and give and make alloys. One type is metal and metal. Another type is metal and non-metal. So this is a definition of alloys. Homogeneous mixture of metal, non-metal, second option, metal and metal. First, take one example of alloys. Mixture of Cu plus Zn and make alloys, name is brass. Another metal, Cu plus tin, give bronze. And mixture of metal, Cu plus Zn metal and make alloys, name is brass. Cu plus tin metal and make alloys, its name is bronze. So two example of alloys. So here the last topic of our chapter. Now solve exercise question. First exercise question of chapter number 3. First question and give four option. First, understand. Blank displacement reaction is follow four option. Option 1 is NaCl solution plus Cu. First is NaCl solution plus Cu. So here Cu does not replace NaCl solution, therefore first possibility is not follow displacement reaction. Next is MgCl2, magnesium chloride plus aluminium metal. Here aluminium is not replace Mg, is a base on reactivity series question. We have to learn what is reactive series and what is order of reactivity of metal. So these rules follow to answer this question. So in this way, second is does not follow displacement reaction because air is does not replace Mg. Third option, FeSO4 plus Ag is also not, because Ag is not displace Fe, because Fe is more reactive than Ag, so does not take place displacement reaction. Last option is AgNO3 plus Cu. Here Cu is more reactive than Ag, Ag means silver, so displacement reaction take place because Cu is more reactive than Ag. Cu is more reactive than Ag. So first answer is AgNO3 plus Cu is can represent a displacement reaction. Next question, prevention of how to prevent iron pan from rusting. We have two given question. Option 4. First question is preventing iron pan to prevent corrosion. First option is applying grease on iron pan surface. So fan used for cooking, so we does not apply grease, because applying grease after some time, grease is included in food. In food we can eat, so does not good for health. The first option is not selected. Applying grease is not selected. Second option, painting, same reason, paint, heat and mix in food in our body, so our body is damaged for this paint. So second option is also not available. Third, coating of zinc is option is right. We have to coating of zinc in iron fan. So option C, coating of zinc in iron fan. Third question, element react one element. We have to give answer which element is react with O2 given compound having high melting point compound, and this compound is soluble in water. Give answer of this element. Which element is react with O2 and produce high melting point compound and produce compound is soluble in water? Four options. First option is calcium. Second option is carbon. Third option is silicon. And fourth option is Fe. So silicon, carbon and Fe. Not easily soluble in water. First, Ca is soluble in water having high melting point. So our answer is Ca. Ca means calcium. Calcium react with O2 gives high melting point compound, and this compound is soluble in water. So recent answer is calcium. Next, food can be coated with tin, not zinc. One question. Food can coated with tin, not zinc. So first we have to compare tin and zinc. Food can fire coated with tin in place of zinc. So give answer. First check reactivity order of these two terms, two metal, tin and zinc. So conclusion is zinc is high reactive metal than tin metal. So food can coated with tin because zinc is high reactive than tin and tin is less reactive than zinc. So food pad can coated with tin, not zinc. Is answer. Next, hammer, battery, bulb, wires and switch. You have to given hammer, battery, bulb, wire and switch. First option, how can you separate between sample of metal and non-metal? And second option, which test too useful identify metal and non-metal? So first lecture we have to learn what is physical properties of metal and non-metal. According to this property, we can simplify and distinguish between metal and non-metal. So first take hammer. Hammer is a hard surface, produce sound, heat in our surface. Stick on surface produce sonorous sound, and hammer is also transfer electricity. So in the basis of these physical properties, hammer can be classify into metal group. In similar way, battery, switch, bulb, we can separate it according to physical properties of metal and non-metal. Now, answer of question 2 from his question. Which test too useful? This all instrument to divide what is metal and non-metal. So we have to battery. Then for connected battery, we have to use switch, battery and take bulb and two end. Between these two end, here we take substrate. And check. Four point substance applied between two end and passes electricity. When bulb is on, then we can say that this substance is transfer of electricity. And between two end, you have to take substance passes electricity and bulb is not on, bulb is off. Therefore, we can say that this substance is not transfer electricity. It means insulator. And not transfer of electricity. So this type of answer. Next, amphoteric oxide. Definition of amphoteric oxide and give two example of amphoteric oxide. Let's solve. First, we understand what is N2-3 oxide. N2-3 oxide means this type of oxide. Which oxide in this type of oxide is react acid and base both and produce salt plus water. So first we understand what is amphoteric oxide. Amphoteric oxide means substance can react acid as well as base. Substance which react as well as acid and base to produce salt plus water in same form base. It means substance react acid and base both and produce salt plus water. This type of substance is known as amphoteric oxide. Once again, amphoteric oxide means react with acid as well as base and produce salt plus water. An example of amphoteric oxide is Al2O3 aluminium oxide react with acid. For example, hydrochloric acid and produce salt plus water. Which type of salt? Here aluminium and chlorine ion produce AlCl3 salt plus H2O. Now balance chemical equation. Here Al is 2, therefore multiply by 2. Cl is 6, so we have to multiply by 6. Cl is 6, so multiply by 6. H is multiplied by 6. H6 here is multiplied by 3. So Al2O3 plus 6HCl gives 2 AlCl3 salt aluminium chloride salt plus H2O. Now this oxide react with acid and produce salt plus water. Now same oxide react with base and produce salt plus water. Al2O3 plus NaOH is a base sodium hydroxide. NaAlO2 salt sodium aluminium oxide plus water. Salt plus water, same production. This one is called amphoteric oxide. Now balance chemical reaction. Here Al is 2, therefore multiply by 2. Now Na is 2, therefore this Na is multiplied by 2. Calculate O. O is 3 plus 2, 5. 2 into 2, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Hydrogen is 2. Here H is 2. So chemically balanced. This is an example of amphoteric oxide. And oxide, amphoteric oxide and Al2O3 is react with acid and as well as base produce same salt plus water. Next example, name two metal which displace hydrogen and also give two metals which does not displace hydrogen. So first one example is metal, name of two metal which displace hydrogen. Again is a base of reactivity series question. So which metal displaced hydrogen? Which metal displaced hydrogen? This type of metal displaces hydrogen when is a more reactive than hydrogen. And which metal is does not displace hydrogen? Is a less reactive than hydrogen. So two metal, suppose Mg, zinc, Fe is a displace H2 gas, hydrogen metal. 2 metal displace H2, name is Mg. FeZn, a metal will displace H2. It means, in short, metal is highly active than H2, so displace H2. Now, example of 2 metal does not displace hydrogen is Cu, Hg, Ag, and Au. So all is a less reactive metal than H2, so does not displace H2 gas. Now, last question. Electrolytic refining of metal M. So this topic is discussed in last lecture. Electrolytic solution to have one container. Put two rods. One rod as a positive part, another rod is a negative part connected to battery. And positive is anode and negative is cathode. And suppose here given question, metal is M. Defining of metal M. Defining of metal M, what is anode, cathode, and electrolyte solution? So defining of metal, it means which metal is impure is connected with positive part and as a anode. So metal M impure connected with positive part anode, and metal M is a pure is connected with negative part cathode, and which is a electrolyte solution. So we have to discuss in this topic which is used as an electrolyte solution, which metal is pure, which metal is purified. So its metal salt solution. So M metal salt solution used as a electrolyte. For example, Cu metal can be pure. So impure Cu connected with anode, pure Cu connected with positive and negative part cathode, and electrolyte solution as a CuSO4. So question number 1 to 8 discuss here. Next question 9 to 15 in discuss next lecture. Thank you, friends.